Hi there. Let's learn how to make some interactive flashcards in PowerPoint.
Let's start by making our cards. So we first go to Insert and then put a rectangle in here for the first card. You can of course make as many of these cards as you like, but I'll go ahead and make this a 3x4 grid like you saw in the intro video. I now need to make sure that my cards will fit on the slide, so I'll just resize them by going to Format, then Size, and I'll change the height of this one to 2.27 and the width to 3.1. Now that we have this rectangle, we can now recolor it as we like, so I'll just make this orange. And then you can add whatever effects you want. So for example, for this one, I'll go to Shape Effects, Presets, and then click on the first one. And not too bad. Now let's practice our shortcuts. Click on the rectangle, then hit Control C to copy, and then Control V to paste. Then make another copy, but this time let's press Control D to duplicate, which saves you a step. And then do it again, duplicate. Notice how if you actually duplicate instead of copy-paste, it will actually try to align the spacing for you as well, which is really useful. Now take the four cards and line them up, and duplicate again to make another row, and duplicate once more to finalize. And we now have the basis for our cards. These rectangles here will be the back side of the cards. And before we do anything else, let's duplicate the slide so that we have rectangles to use for the front a little bit later. Let's recolor those to be blue. The example I'll be showing you here is flashcards with the PowerPoint shortcuts, which means the cards have questions on the front and answers on the back, which will be on these yellow cards here. So I'll start with the top left by putting the shortcuts for the cut, copy, paste, and duplicate commands. So I'll write the keys for them here. Now let's make the font bold and increase the size to 28. And let's change the color to black there. Now let's just demonstrate another shortcut, which is the pick up and apply style. And this is sort of similar to the Format Painter, which lets you copy the style of one object to another. However, the advantage of the pick up and apply style commands is that you can pick up style once and then apply it for as long as you want, anywhere, even on other slides. So it's a lot easier than the Format Painter. So I pick up the style here on this card by hitting Control Shift C, and then I select everything, or you can also use Control A, and then hit Control V to paste the style to all the other cards. And as you can see, the format settings have changed up here to reflect the changes we just made. At this point, I'll write in all the other shortcuts until my rectangles look like this. And now let's do the same thing for the blue rectangles. Write cut, copy, paste, and duplicate on the top left one. And let's make it bold or hit Control B and increase the font to 36. Now hit Control Shift C to pick up the style. Hit Control A to select everything or hold and drag as we did before. And now do Control Shift V to paste the style around the other rectangles. And then fill them in with the other appropriate commands. And again, this will be the front of my cards. And by the way, if you want to make a memory game in which you don't know what's on the back side of the cards, leave all of these blue front cards blank. Okay, awesome. We're done with our cards, so let's start animating them. Go back to the first slide with the yellow cards, select all of them, go to the Animations tab and add animation. Then more entrance effects. And if you have PowerPoint 2013, select the stretch animation. If you have an earlier version, you can still get a similar effect by using split. You just have to make sure that you go to the effect options afterwards and make it vertical out. And if you really want to get fancy, you can also use the swivel entrance effect, which I show you in another video. Okay, for this though, let me go back and put the animation back to stretch. Now go to start and say after previous, and then make the timing 0.25 in duration. So that's done. Let's go to the other slide now and also add an animation to everything. This time, an exit animation of collapse. Again, you can use a split exit effect as well if you have an older version of PowerPoint, as I show you here. And let's go back to collapse though for this demonstration. And we are now ready to combine both sets of cards on one slide. So select all the cards, cut them or do Control X, and then paste or hit Control V on the next slide and adjust everything so that the blue cards are exactly on top of the yellow. Finally, go to the animation pane and drag the red exit effects to the very top. Decrease the duration to 0.25. And great, we're ready to start adding the triggers. If you have a lot of cards here like I do, this can be a little tricky, but it'll be worth it in the end if you have enough patience. First, start by working on the top left rectangle, and let's mouse over the top exit effect to make sure that's the one that we're working with here. And yes, it is. It says cut, copy, paste, etc. So now we right click and go to timing. Here we go to the triggers, then add trigger on click of. Now select the same rectangle that you're currently on from the list. Since this one is the cut and copy one, the one that's written out, not the shortcut side. What this does is it makes it so that when you click on that rectangle in presentation mode, it goes away or flips over automatically. However, as the top of the card goes away, we need the bottom of the card to come in so it looks like a flip effect. So we have to find the corresponding entrance effect and mouse over this top one here. And it's indeed the Control X and Control C rectangle, which is cut and copy, which is the one that we want. Now we drag this one down below the trigger animation. So now we get the full flip effect, as you see here. Continue this process with the rest of the effects until your animation pane looks something like this. There should be 12 sets here if you're using 12 cards. Okay, now the cards will be able to flip over if we click on them, but they won't be able to flip back yet until we do the exact same process on the other side. And yes, that means another 12 sets of triggers. And patience is really the key here. So now we basically reverse the process. So we have to start with the yellow cards and add an exit effect to them. But first, we actually have to see them. So we select each of the blue cards and make sure to click while holding control so that you can select multiple ones. And you can also use the selection pane for this, by the way, if you prefer. Now right click and then send to back so that we can see the yellow cards again. And then select them using the same process. And then go to add animation, more exit effects, and add the collapse effect or the split exit effect for previous versions of PowerPoint, as we mentioned before. And as we did earlier, make the duration 0.25. Now select the yellow cards once again. I'm sure you're becoming an expert now at selecting stuff. And then send them to the back again. And select the blue cards. And now we'll add the entrance effect by going to add animation again, more entrance effects, and then selecting stretch or split for earlier versions of PowerPoint. Make everything start after previous and make the duration 0.25 as we did before. And you probably know the drill by now. Go to the top exit animation. As a reminder, this is for the bottom cards, which you can't see right now. Mouse over it and it says rectangle 49. Even though we can't fully see the shortcut, we can guess that it's the one corresponding to font size since that animation box is highlighted in pink on the left. So we right click and go to timing, then go to the triggers menu. Now look for rectangle 49 in the menu. Select that and hit OK. Now find the corresponding rectangle for the change font size card, rectangle 4 in this case, and then drag it down under the rectangle 49 trigger. Again, repeat this process until you have all your triggers done for this side as well. You should have 24 pairs of triggers by the time you're done. One to flip the cards over, and then the other one to flip them back. And if you've made it this far, pat yourself on the back because you've had a lot of patience. And as a reward, this is what you should be able to do with your cards. How cool is this? Click to flip once and then click to flip again. And you can basically do this forever and the slide will never end on you. And you can use this template for many things, flashcards or memory games or fun quizzes for your class. And the great thing is you can change the text on the cards so that you can keep reusing this over and over. Well, thanks again for watching, especially if you're still with me, and hope you enjoyed and see you for my next video.